Hi everyone, welcome to javatechie. So in this tutorial, let's take a look at what is Angular material and how to use it to build a modern UI. Okay, so basically ng material is a UI component library, and also it provides us some inbuilt component to build an awesome UI in a quick time. So let's go to the ng official page to understand more about this component. So if you'll search Angular material in your browser, you'll get this link, Angular Material UI Component Library. So if you'll click on this link, it will redirect you to the material documentation. Okay, so if you can see here, there is a tab called components. So if you click on this components, you can view all the components given by Angular Material. So if you want to add form kind of thing, then you can use this form controller component. If you want to add navigation navbar in your application, you can use this navigation component. Similarly, for layout and grid, there is layout component. Even you can find multiple buttons and indicators, pop-ups and modals, and data table. Okay, but our main focus here to use this ng data table concept with pagination, sorting, and filtering. Okay, so in today's example, I will show you demo of how we can use this data table. Then going forward, we'll use this same data table example to build a coronavirus tracker. Okay, so let's begin with the development. Let's get started. So first, let's create one Angular project. Go to your Visual Studio Code. Then I'll move to this root directory. Here we'll create a project called ng new. Then I can specify my project name as javatechie COVID-19 tracker. Okay. Now let's create this Angular project. So for this example, I don't want to use this routing concept. I will use no. Then enter. So let's wait it to create the project first. Yeah, so finally our project created successfully. Now let's import this to our ID. Go to this open folder and I'll search with this javatechie COVID-19 tracker. Okay, select this folder. Now go to the terminal. Fine. So as we are going to use this Angular material, we need to follow the guide given by this Angular material. So if you will click on this guides, then click on this getting started. Now if you will come down, there is an instruction to install this Angular material. Okay. So just copy this command, then go to your project and run this command. In our project, we need to add few dependency from this Angular material. So if you run this command, it will add all the required dependency in our project. So it will take a couple of seconds as I am doing it first time. Then you can see here, it is asking us to use the theme. So I will use this custom. Then set up this, I just click no. I just want to use this browser animation, I will click yes. Now it will update our project. Yeah, so if you observe here, it updated app.module.ts and this package.json. So if you go to this package.json and if you search with this dependency with the string material, so you can see here, it added the Angular material dependency of this version. And also, if you'll go to your app.module.ts, so let's go inside this app folder, it added one more module, which is browser animation module. Okay. So now let's go to our documentation. Click on this component, click on this data table, because we are going to use this data table, right? So as of now, I'm not going to show you the demo of pagination and sorting and filtering. We'll just create one simple table using this Angular material. So in next tutorial, I will add all the component one by one. So let's click on this table. So here even you can directly get the source code. We no need to use our brain to design this user interface. That's what the beauty of this Angular component. So we just want to create some table, right? So if you click on this, you will find the source code. So go to this TypeScript. Then you can see here. So let me come down. This is what the interface, and these are the hard code value. This value we want to display in our table, okay, which will be Angular data table. And if you will come down, there is nothing. You just need to set those element data, which is the array, this data. If you observe, the name of variable is element data. This data we just need to bind to our data source. And if you will come to your HTML, from data source HTML will render those value. And you need to use this predefined template, okay? But if you want to customize your alignment or layout, that you can add additional CSS. So for this demo purpose, I will just use the same code. So go to this TS and let me copy this interface. So we'll go to our app.component.ts. So just add it here. Also, if you want, you can create this as a separate TS file. Okay. All right. Now let's assign some value to this periodic element. So go to this TypeScript and let me copy this hard code value. And you can add it in your code. So in this example, I just want to show this hard code value in our ng data table. But in our next tutorial, we'll fetch actual coronavirus details from other REST API. Okay, then I will display those value rather than showing this hard code value. Now again, go to the TypeScript. And if you'll come down, you just need to add this element data, which is the hard code value, to data source. And this display column you need to specify. I will explain the purpose of using this display column. So let's copy this. Now go to your code and let's add it here. Fine. So all the hard code value, these are the hard code value we added to this data source, and we specify the display columns. So if you observe here, the display column is position, name, weight and symbol. With the same signature, you need to specify in your HTML file. Okay. In table header, we need to specify the same signature. This is the case sensitive. Either you need to use the lowercase or uppercase. Now let's save this file. Now go to the code. And if you will go to this HTML, let me copy the entire HTML. And now let's go to our code and go to our app.component.html. So let me remove all. Yeah. So let me minimize this so that I can explain you. So if you observe here, this is the component given by Angular material, which is the mat table, and it is binding the data source which we are giving from this component.ts, right? This is the data source, and we are binding element data to this data source. So if you go to this element data, these are the hard code value we are adding to our data source, and the same value we are rendering from our HTML page. That's why we specify the data source here, and this is the template we need to use. So if you observe the first line, mat column def is position. You should mention the same what you mention as part of your display column. So if you go to this app.component.ts, so this display columns, position, name, weight, symbol, same things you need to specify in your HTML file. So if you observe your position, name, weight, because this is the case sensitive, okay? And if you come to this header, you can give this any name. And this is what the table definition. From the data source, we can extract all the field, okay? Element.position, element.name, element.weight. These are the value which specified in our periodic element, right? This is what the interface, we specify these four value: name, position, weight and symbol. The same value we are getting extracted from our data source. Okay. Now what I can do, let me save this. Then let me save this component.ts. Now let me open the terminal. So let's run our application. So here we'll get the exception, but we'll find the answer from that exception, because there is lot of component. We can't remember all the component tag and all. So based on the exception, we'll identify which dependency or which module we need to add in our app.module.ts. So let me run this first. Yeah, it will take some time. Yeah, so you can see here our application is up. Now go to this browser. Let me inspect this. So if you observe here, can't bind data source since it is not a known property of this table, mat table. Okay, it means we need to add mat table modules in our app.module.ts, because this is coming from the Angular material. This is not part of the Angular. This component we need to add in our app.module.ts. So go to the app.module.ts. Come here, and in this import section we need to add mat table module, and we need to add the import statement. Okay, so let me copy the name properly. Yeah, now save this. Now let me refresh this. Okay, we didn't save or what. Yeah, let me save this. It's compiled successfully. Now let's go to the browser. Better let me open it in. Yeah, we got the response, but let me show you that in our Chrome. Yeah, you can see here we got the table number, name, width and symbol. But this is not properly aligned. So what I can do, let me specify the table width. So go to this app.component.cs, specify the table, and I'll specify the width 100%. Okay. Now go to the browser. Yeah, you can see here, right? All the record getting printed, whatever the hard code value you added in our component.ts file, is getting rendered in our HTML. Okay, so the advantages of using this Angular material. So I will show you that if you will inspect this, and if you will come here, click on this mobile mode, this will be auto format. Okay, so it will be compatible with all the device. You can change the height and width. It's alternate to the bootstrap, we can say. So based on your mobile height and width, it will be automatically compatible with that particular device. That's what the beauty of using this Angular material. Okay, so in my next tutorial, I will show you how we can fetch and map those data to this data source rather than hard code this value. Okay, so we'll do the REST API call to actual coronavirus tracker API given by some third party, and I will display those record in this HTML page. Okay. That's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.